Daddy, what did you want to drink?
Granddad.
What did you want to drink?
Hi, my name is William Michael Barbee. I'm the youngest of five children born to Otha Donald Barbee and Josephine Priscilla Williams Barbee. I started doing video documentary when I started watching so many of my elder statesmen pass off the scene. Many of my uncles and aunts, as well as my dad who recently passed. I wanted to have a recording, some type of video documentary of them interacting with us. I never had the honor of meeting my grandparents, as in my grandfather Albert Williams, who is the brother of my great aunt who founded the church, Zion Holy Church, nor my grandmother Gertrude Phil Williams. I did have the pleasure of meeting her sisters, Rosa, Alice, and Minnie. Those older statesmen who passed on were able to seed into our lives through their children, who consist of my mom and her nine brothers and sisters. I've been truly blessed with such a rich legacy to uphold as well as inherit. It is my goal that I can forever be a tool or measure that others following me would know the rich history from which we've come. I trust that this documentary, if it does anything, I hope it stays with you, that you too would know that family is the most important element in life, and without them, we're nothing. So I hope you sit back and enjoy what has been presented in this documentary. God bless you and peace.
Everybody say hi.
Hi.
Uncle Willie, that's you too. Uncle Willie. This is Uncle Willie. Now Rosa, say hello.
She just celebrated her 80th birthday.
Yo, what up, man? Rich. Rich, like, yeah, what's up, man? Yeah. Station break. What'd you say?
He told me to make that time.
Hold on. And then?
She the woman, so she the boss. So she go and she turn. Then she made a phone call and said, call Michael. Mike, you need to check your phone.
No, my phone in the car.
Oh, that's good. Push me straight.
Station break.
Okay. I made the phone call because evidently we were lost. Thank you, baby.
Michael, didn't you tell me it was about?
Mike said that they got something from all of us, and they got lying from me. This is not true. I didn't tell Mike that I was Superman. I said I could fly.
Family meant a lot to my parents. I had the pleasure of meeting my father's mother, we refer to as Granny. Even though my dad was the only child, she filled in the gaps for the absence, I guess, of our other grandparents. She referred to all of us as Tweety, and I guess that's why my dad here in the photo is close to his grandkids as well.
Yes, sir.
No, no, don't talk to Tom
Mitchell.
I got one of you though, bro. Hey, I got one of you, bro, with your face going up.
Stop smiling. Say hi. Say hi.
With love and grace. No one can take your place.
Hey, Chris, you're a star now. Go ahead, Tiff.
Wait, hang on. Tiff needs a top eight.
Tiff, come on.
Oh, wait.
That's motivation.
Yes, it's me.
You ain't getting nowhere like that.
I see the blue for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I hear babies cry, I watch them grow. They'll learn much more than I'll ever know. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Now, Craig, you're going to need
the
somebody.
The colors of the rainbow.
He's got me right here.
There's people passing by. There are also on the faces of people passing by. I see friends shaking hands. Saying, how do you do? They're always saying, I love you.
Nice voice.
Then you're going to need a backup singer, and then pretty soon she's going to need a backup singer.
No, 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 I need some.
I'm going to do a contract with the Carnival to Bahamas.
Oh, yeah? What?
Yeah, Carnival Cruise, Bahamas, and they pay. So I'm putting a band, and I'm looking for background singers.
Okay,
wait. Are you in the
school? Hey, Gene sounds like Barbee. Leave her alone.
Hey, Tanya, what you say?
No.
As you see, this is what family's about, having good times at the holidays. My sister Tanya, she got to be one of the biggest clowns in the family. She came into family, married my brother Mark, and it seemed as if they made for each other. Jean, she always in the camera, always in the way, usually the loudest mouth in the room. But we enjoy her nonetheless. Without Jean, I don't know what life would be like. She's always been that, I would have to say, the person who was the most optimistic out of all of us. She was really a good energy, positive energy, most times, if not all. I do appreciate her as well. My sister Marcia was the oldest and is the oldest. And often she just comes out of left field with some pitch or some perspective on things. But when you sit back and think about it, it's usually profound. We love each and every one of our family members for all their efforts and all their contributions. My mom, she's always in her own world. Sometimes she's giving comments and it takes a moment before they actually settle in, before we really understand what it's about. But I truly miss times of old, but I treasure this video, knowing that it's going to always be with me forever. Continue to enjoy. Take care.
Analysis parties, you know, everybody's walking by like this.
He's videotaping that. I hope he got on tape, Mark. I hope he got your analysis.
I never know what time is it, brother.
Huh? What time is it?
It's 3 in a row time.
Showtime. Brother Ray. Deacon, what's up? Brother-in-law. Wait, I forgot I had it downstairs.
Hey,
wait.
Hi.
Hey, roommates. Oh, what is a sweet mate? What's a sweet mate?
Hey, Mike. We all live together.
Yeah,
we have a room together.
Ah, get on out of here. Go on and play your game.
Mike, you got something in your nose.
But hang on, Michael. Eric is shooting. Eric is shooting. Shh. Wait a minute. Shh. Jenny's shooting. That's Tiffany's roommate. She's the one that she was talking about.
Now that's the sweet. That's the sweet mate.
She's the one that snores at night.
Mike.
She the one that snores at night, huh?
Mark,
you know, she the one who snores at night. She the one who snores at night.
Eric is gonna make a shot.
Oh, Eric, you good. Dude, Eric, make that one way over in the corner.
I live with them.
Hey, Gene.
I really don't. I don't.
You know what Jane was saying?
What?
Danny weighed 235.
Now that, you know, you did that with poise. Do it again. Just like the worst of us.
Danny been telling people he weigh 190.
Hey, yeah, I do.
And Jada said, no, he weigh 235.
Daddy, Jada also says the world is square, Jada.
When I think about my father in this state, no matter what the situation was, my father was always composed, trying to make even people happy at the saddest times. Here he is at Uncle Willie's funeral, but yet he's smiling, walking in, escorting his daughter-in-law, Jean Woods Barbee. My dad was a phenomenal man. I just hope one day I can lead my family in the manner in which he led us. He left much to be reckoned and big shoes for us to fill. And I'm sure each and every one of us will have to walk in his shoes one day just to be a half of the man that he was. He was a short man in stature, but he was a giant in each and every one of our lives.
We need a solo.
I would have to say that my mom, Josephine, was the glue that kept us all together. My dad was a black and white man, whereas my mom was gray. She always kept it pretty calm, pretty neutral. But when I think about their combination, they produce some outstanding offspring. Not to say just because it's me. My father always was the one who, as he got older, he just became a very mellow guy. But whether he was clueless to what was going on, he always had an opinion. Always had an opinion.
Tell them all the part. Tell them I'm telling you who I am. What is my name?
I'm sorry, he's not Daddy. He's Mr. Daddy.
Ah, sit down.
He called my job the other day.
Mr. Daddy.
Called my job the other day and wanted to know who did I think I was. Did I, you know, who do I, am I grown, that grown where I can't salute him correctly? And I'm like, Daddy, I'm at work. I'm on the job. He said, I don't care where you
My family's a rather dynamic group of people. I don't know what life would be without any of them. My father, who recently passed, was a hard-working man, very debonair in his appearance and the way he carried himself, very responsible. My mom, she was the glue that kept us together. She was basically the nurturer of all of us. She's someone who I will always respect, honor, love, and adore. Together, they put a lot of work into making us into successful children. My dad loved kids. He loved playing with kids. He was the father who, while you're in school, you'll get into a fight and he'll yell at you in front of the teacher. But after school, he'll pull you aside and say, "Did you win? Did you win? Did you win? Did you win?" I remember when we moved on Hobson Street. Well, once we lived on Hobson Street, I was maybe 2 months. But we all went to the same elementary school, Burgoyne Avenue School. There we had fun. It was one student from Marcia to Marty to Gene, Mark, and myself. It was easy for me going to elementary school because my brothers and sisters made life in the academic as well as the image of the teachers real easy. But most important, I just take this time to just think about the life that my parents gave us and how proud I am of them and the joyous nature in which they seeded into all of our lives. Again, I hope you enjoy this video documentary of my family. And may God ever bless and keep each and every one of you. Thanks for watching. Please enjoy. Would be gone from me if I could steal one final glance, one final step, one final dance with him. I'd play a song that would never ever end, 'cause I'd love, love, love to dance with my father again. Sometimes I'd listen outside her door, and I'd hear how my mother cried for him. I pray for her even more than me. I pray for her even more than me. To dance with my father again. Every night I fall asleep, and this is all I ever dream.
First time there's nothing to cry about. She wears the stars in her eyes, and she looks and she sees into this heart of mine. I can survive after any lover.
Love can go wrong
one way or another, but this time I'm right. This time I know it.
This time I know that it's love till the end. Yesterday's over, I'm starting again.
And this time I'm right. This time I know it's
love.
Love. Surely, surely, ain't no love like she. And she told me that I'm the reason she lives. Comes to me all the time. I'm not just making her up in my mind. I know
it. Can we have everybody's attention, please?
Did they hear you?
They heard that.
Can we have everybody's attention?
Hello?
Marsha has something she wants to say.
Okay. Hop out.
Mike has got something he wants to say. What do you want to say, Mike?
The ball in your court.
Please don't put it in the mouth.
Oh, that's what we have. No, no.
I just wanted to thank everybody for coming out and helping Josie celebrate her birthday. We are Josie's Pussycats. And her monkeys. And we just wanted to say happy birthday, Mom. And that we love you dearly. And we wish you many, many more. Am I right?
Yeah!
Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday, dear Joey! Happy birthday to you!
Josie speaks! Josie speaks! Who's speaking?
I was truly surprised, and what happened was my birthday was last week, and
2 weeks ago.
Two weeks ago. And and my husband, he's known in our family. He always denies it, but he's known. He can't keep secrets. And he has one child who has his top trait too. We won't name her right now.
Name but two.
Man, I'm not a partier, so it didn't like bother me. But it's just I had the expectation after hearing hit the other inside of my face. And it was just fun. You know, I was happy. And here, 2 weeks later. But I thank everyone who shared in it with me. Anybody that knows me know I love people, and you know I love my family. My family is it. And today, almost everybody that I've seen, I consider family.
All right.
They, this is the relationship either between me and them, or me and them through my children, or my sisters and brothers, or whatever.
Jenna Willis.
I've missed some, but you that are here have really made a day for me.
That's all.
Wow.
Mike, turn around. Wow.
All right, so happy birthday, Ma, and you got a cup of
cake.
Okay,
yeah,
any Jell-O?
Me too.
Yeah.
Janelle wants to know.
Whatever you want. You want to take it home?
Mommy.
Oh, you want to take mommy home? Mm-hmm.
Oh, she's going to carve it out the middle of the cake?
That's right.
Hey, just cut it from. Gene, just cut the whole.
Yeah, cut the middle.
Dodo.
Oh, I know.
Cut the thing down now.
He said Dodo.
We're going to square around the middle and then cut the pieces along the edge and take them out.
Gene, you're singing a solo?
No, Laverne is.
When?
Annalise going to sing a solo.
Right behind
No, but you singing, Annalise. Yeah, you singing. Get ready. Get set and go. Miss Richardson back there looking at you like you're crazy. No, Spin's gonna sing a song. Dwayne!
Sing,
Dwayne!
Look.
Dwayne's the music producer.
Yes, we got a couple of music fans.
What's that?
Something that won't
kill you. Tiffany! Tiffany's about to sing a song, Gene.
Happy birthday, and many, many more. Be safe,
because
Godspeed, may you
mine.
Happy birthday, and I wish you had many, 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 many more birthdays.
Josh.
I'm going to give a birthday dance.
Okay, give a birthday dance.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
There's my pastor right there.
And my
mother, what's up?
I just talking to your pastor about you.
Okay. He believes it.
Hey, he knows it.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, what are you getting?
Brother-in-law. What's up, man?
I need you to carry
on. Oh, they're the Pattersons. Hey, there's someone. Still in. Hey, what's your name? What's your name?
Bam!
Birthday wish.
Happy birthday!
America's most wanted. What's up, man? What's up, man?
What's up?
Yeah, what you doing? What you doing? Dylan just got here. Look at that. Look at that. And then we have a nosy one. And there's the other one. Mr. Jahan. Mr. Curry, how are you?
Oh, she likes attention.
Birthday wish. Crazy. I'm Mary. Birthday wish. Birthday wish.
Say happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
We love you. Hope you see 60 more.
How you doing, man?
It's open. Go ahead.
You good? You sure? Mm-hmm. All right. Hey.
What's up, man? How you feel? Good, good.
I love that thing you sent me.
Which, hey, Douglas. You know,
check us out. We'll be.
Hi. Hey, it's a happy birthday wish.
How
are you?
I'm blessed. You have to wish happy birthday, Mommy.
Happy birthday, Cousin Josephine.
There you go.
Many, 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 many more.
Bless you. Hey.
How you doing, sweetie? Finally get to your house, huh?
This your first time?
Yes.
I know Steve's been here.
Yes, why did you get me lost? With a directional signal. With all direction there. I said, why don't we take 20? We took 23. We ran on Mount Pleasant Avenue.
Because that's your husband.
Your father said that to me this morning. Don't let him drive.
Hey, right.
Well, you even know that already. Hey, birthday with Steve.
Hey, Steve. Yeah. Steve has my
happy birthday, dear baby. You know I love you.
My dad found his calling when he got saved. It was then the church that he found a new purpose, a new meaning for life. I remember he was honored with the position of being the first organizer as well as chairman for the men's department for our family church, Zion Holy Church. There, many people were honored and recognized for their many accomplishments, and even those who you would least expect, my father was there to encourage them to continue in the process of giving. As I reflect back on my growing up in the church under my father, he would bring us to church as if it was our duty and responsibility. There we were put in positions to sing when I know I could sing, but Mark was a singer, Marty played the drums. But in hindsight, I just think back to us growing up as a unit, as a family, from the oldest one, my sister Marcia, and the rearing of her children. She had the three beautiful children, Eric, Tiffany, and April. And I know that was one of Daddy's main joys, is watching his grandkids, because he always reflected on his childhood and his grandfather that he had. I remember one of his greatest joys was being able to give both his daughters away at their weddings. That really made him proud. And I hope you just get just a glimpse of who my father was and what he represented. May God ever bless and keep you. Peace.
Just for me.
different character, you know?
Is that right?
Oh, you knew what to say.
Hey, hey!
Nala, how you doing, Chad?
How you feel?
I'm fine.